guys, this is Lim with Lim Reviews, and today I would like to show you a quick hands-on of the Huawei Nova 4e. So this is the latest mid-range smartphone by Huawei, and it's a sibling to the Huawei Nova 4. The Nova 4e comes with slightly lower specs and a lower price, but before we take a closer look, let's see what's in the box. So I really want to thank the guys at Huawei Subang Parade for giving me this opportunity to make this video at their shop. Inside the box, apart from the Nova 4e itself, the box also contains a screen protector, a silicone case which is currently not here, some manuals, a quick charge charger, Type-C cable, and a pair of earphones. That's basically everything you'll need to get started on the Nova 4e. It must be noted that the Nova 4e I have here is the 6GB RAM with 128GB memory variant and is sold for 1200 ringgit or approximately $300. Now that we have the unboxing and price out of the way, let me give you a quick hands-on and my first impressions on the Huawei Nova 4e. The Nova 4e is about $90 cheaper than the Nova 4, but retains its amazing build quality and design. This is not the first time Huawei has did a design like this, but I still love the way Huawei creates its back panels. Like always, when you tilt the Nova 4e from side to side, you'll notice that it creates this rather unique light waves pattern, which looks really cool. It also has this shade of purple mixed with blue, and this reminds me of the Honor 8X. Other than that, the Nova 4e feels really solid in hand and gives you that premium feel. In terms of the display, the Nova 4e uses an LCD panel that is bright and vibrant. It is also really sharp with a screen density of 415 pixels per inch. That, my friends, is way higher than the iPhone XR that costs 3 times more than the Nova 4e. During my short time with the Nova 4e, I actually placed it side by side with the Nova 4, and it felt to me that the Nova 4e had a better display here. I can't say how well it'll perform outdoors, but so far, the display seems to be really bright indoors and really promising. Moving on, let's talk about what's under the hood of the Nova 4e. Its bigger brother, the Nova 4, has a Kirin 970, but the Nova 4e is only given a Kirin 710. This is Huawei's mid-range processor and is comparable to the Snapdragon 660. Having said so, the model I have has 6GB of RAM, so I'm not too worried about performance. During my short period with the Nova 4e, navigating has been pretty smooth, but I will have to use it for a couple more days and do some heavy gaming before deciding if its performance is as good, if not better than the Snapdragon 660. Moving on to the back of the device, we can see that the Nova 4e comes fully loaded with 3 sensors. Here, we have a 24MP main camera, an 8MP ultra-wide camera, and a 2MP depth camera for those portrait images. I did manage to take a couple of sample indoor shots for you to judge and evaluate, but bear in mind that this is just an early look at the camera. I plan to get this outdoors and see what it can do with all those sensors. Another feature Huawei is really proud with is the AI selfie camera. Huawei says this is their highest ever resolution selfie camera at 32MP, so expect selfies to turn out razor sharp. We've not talked enough about the cameras, let's check out the samples I took. Alright, now that we've done with the photo samples, other things that you need to know include the battery that comes on the Nova 4e. Huawei has given us a 3340 mAh battery here, so that should give you at least a day of use on one full charge. As mentioned earlier on in the video, the Nova 4e also supports fast charge through its Type-C port and included fast charger, so we should expect pretty solid battery performance here. Nevertheless, I will definitely cover this in my full review. On that note, it's worth mentioning that the Huawei Nova 4e still retains the headphone jack, so that's definitely good to know. Alright guys, that's it so far for the quick look at the Huawei Nova 4e. My first impressions have been really positive and there are many things to like about the Nova 4e. However, please stay tuned for my full review which should come up in a week or so. As always, let me know in the comment sections below if you have any questions. Also, hit that like button and subscribe if you like this video as I definitely need your support. Thank you so much and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye!